Okay. Hello, I'm Alex from A.P.Ink. So, picking up where I left off last time, I was working on Britney Spears, kind of like a mini paper album, just meant to be like artwork. So, what I want to do today is I'm not really happy with what I did for the kind of album cover, I guess. So I want to try to come up with at minimum at least one more, but maybe two more, depending on how time goes, different versions. So I'm going to use this one as a template so I don't have to try to figure out measurements. Was going to use pencil, but I think I'll just go in with marker right off. So I've got the Ohuhu fine line drawing pen. This is a 0.05 that I'm going to use just to trace this. Okay, I meant to have all this ready, but let me just pull up a reference really quick. Actually, never mind. I was gonna pull up reference for Britney Spears' albums, but I think I'll just wing it like I attempted to here. So, I don't know how much you guys really care about my own personal experience in the art world. So, I am actually a professional artist, regardless of what any of you think of my art ability. I mean, art in general is subjective, but certainly good art is also subjective. But for a time, I actually did work with a band for a time. Mocked up their band name. Worked on an album for them. Managed their their social media presence. But in doing that, it was a matter of mocking up, I think, two or three different versions of their band name. And then I just let them pick which one they liked the best. And that was after, you know, meeting with the band for a bit to get a feel for kind of like what they liked, what they preferred. Trying to decide exactly how I want to lay this one out. I was thinking like diagonally, but I think, didn't she have a thing to do with butterflies, or was that Mariah Carey? thinking maybe something a bit more simple. Maybe just like a. Maybe a really light kind of. So, I'm gonna switch to Ohuhu fineliner drawing pen 0.1. Nowhere near the cleanest. I could go over that with something thicker to try to hide the shakiness of it. Okay, I think I'll go with the 1.0 to try to clean this up a little bit. I don't really think that's any better. Also, I don't know if it's just the thickness of this marker versus this marker, but the 0.1 almost is gray compared to the 1.0. I'm gonna give that a minute to dry before I erase the pencil. Actually, I think while I let that dry, I will. I'm not sure what happened. If my mic was off this entire time. So I'm just letting that dry. I just mocked up the next one just to try to keep things going. So I'm gonna go through and erase the pencil here. I don't know if there's a new glitch on Twitch, because this happened to me last time too, where I was talking and then noticed that my mic was muted, where I didn't mute the mic. Okay, so I went through and pulled the same colors that I used before here. So I'm thinking maybe of some kind of gradient. And I got these colors based on the reference that I was using to draw this. And I'm not going to care too much about going outside the lines here because I'm going to cut this out when I'm done. Says the bad part about this kind of paper. Even as late as I tried to go, I still pressed the paper so you can see my first attempt. I'm going to sharpen this really quick. If I was going to do this the right way, I would mock up the gradient digitally and then add the text on top. But this isn't for a client, this is just for fun. Sharpen this really quick. Yeah, if I were to do this the right way, I would do it digitally, and the gradient would be a lot less patchy than what I'm getting here. I'm sure that's my fault. The supplies I'm using versus the paper I'm using, but I'm gonna move on to the next, and then I'll cut them both out at the end. Trying to decide how I want to do this one. Maybe something a bit more artistic. Make sure I've got this. That looks cockeyed. Okay, I think for this one, I'm gonna go in with the 1.0. Okay, I'll give that a minute to dry. Marvel at how crooked everything is. Which really, if I was going to do this for an actual client, this would be another reason why I would be doing this digitally and not traditionally, just to make sure everything was in line. Let me sharpen this really quick. Let me sharpen this one too. I'm just trying to even out this gradient so you can't see the paper through. So a really light gradient. But I said at the start of this one that I think this one might be a bit more artistic. Let me sharpen this one really quick. Okay. So it's really lighter than I intended. These pencils don't really want to work on top of each other. Okay. So I'm just going to cut these out. Okay. So for the, between the three of these, I'm almost thinking this one. I tried to use the lighter kind of fuchsia color, but it's not really standing up. So I'm gonna go with the darker one to try to go over these lighter flowers. Okay, I forgot to set this step up, but I'm gonna try to finish these so I can actually put this inside it. Let me go get the supplies I need. I will be right back. Okay, so what I was thinking of doing was just kind of wrapping three sides of these so I could fit the cardboard paper in. So I've got just really cheap kind of kids grade paper. I'm not sure, but I think I might be able to get all three with this. So if I trifold this, As much as I tried, I don't think I got this straight. This is gonna be on the back, so I don't care necessarily if it's clean. It would be nice if it was, but... I don't know if this is really going to work. Yeah, that should be okay. So... Okay, I'm figuring this out as I work on it right now, so give me a minute. Make sure this is actually gonna fit. would actually make more sense just to try to wrap the paper around. And then it would just be a matter of cutting off this extra. So I do have a glue stick. I'm thinking maybe tape would be the way to go to seal this edge. I mean, probably glue stick too, but I'm so impatient. I could use these scraps to make sure that nothing ends up gluing this bit. Let me do the other ones. I mean, it's going to be a little bit bigger because I wrapped it around the outside. But I want to make sure that there'll actually be enough room. So I'm not going to fiddle with it too much. I'll probably leave it just that little bit extra. So I don't want to get glue all over my cutting board. So I've just got a glue stick. I don't know. I'm thinking tape is probably going to be the best way for this edge, just so it doesn't end up getting glued together. So let me go get some tape really quick. I'll be right back. So I'm just going to tape this edge, which probably isn't the best way because it'll probably end up. I think just to stop the tape from grabbing the album or the insert, whatever, I'm going to use the cover to fold the paper over just a little bit. Just like that. I'm just going to do that step on all three of them right off. I'm just using the paper as kind of a straight edge to hopefully try to get that straight. So from here, I'm just going to glue this and attach. Okay, it's not the cleanest. I'm purposely trying to get this seam on the inside so it'll be sandwiched between the front and the clean or whatever, but just so this doesn't end up getting ripped open or whatever. Okay, I'm gonna use a ruler to cut off the extra. Okay, so now I basically have three covers for this. I think the only thing I didn't do that I should have was actually glue that inside flap down. I think I'm just gonna stick a piece of tape just because the record is catching it. Just to make sure everything is okay. Okay. I like this one, but I think this one might fit the album better. But I'm gonna put these under something kind of heavy and flat until the glue dries. But that's the first one. And again, just as a reminder, this was the art, album art or CD art, whatever, that inspired it. But I do plan on doing more of these. I know this is kind of not necessarily what I've done in the past, but I think it's a fun project. I hope anybody watching this is enjoying it. Yeah, if you did enjoy this, please make sure that you're following me and that your notifications are turned on for the next time that I do go live. And yeah, enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye.